Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome back to the Super Mario Bros. 3 playthrough. In our last episode, we continued our journey through World 7, Pipeland, and in this episode, we are set to begin the final stretch, the home stretch. And hopefully in this video, we can actually finish off World 7 and finally make our way to World 8. And we are going to get started with World 7-9. Now, 7-9 represents the final normal level of World 7, as in it's the final level with a number in its name. And this level changes things up quite a bit compared to the previous levels we've gone through. Most of the levels in World 7 have featured plenty of crazy piranha plant shenanigans. This level goes in a different direction, befitting the name of Pipeland. This level features a pipe maze, or rather a maze constructed of pipes. Luckily, it may seem daunting at first, but once you figure out exactly where you need to go, the exact path that you need to take, you can get through this level relatively easily and relatively quickly, which we're going to do the best we can. You can clear a path by knocking away ice blocks, and you can also jump up or drop through gaps in the pipes themselves in order to make your way through. Along the way, you're going to have an opportunity to grab several clusters of coins, like these little beauties right here. Might as well go ahead and grab some, nothing wrong with some extra coins. Mario is going to be a very rich man by the time this playthrough is done. Although he doesn't really collect coins for the monetary value, that's more Wario's territory. And there's the warp pipe right here that you need to drop into. And that's all she wrote for 7-9. And now, from the final normal level of World 7, we move on to the final fortress level. And for this level, I'm going to equip a very special power-up, the Hammer Suit. This is a power-up I've been holding on to for quite a while, and this level is actually the specific reason for holding on to it, because this power-up can actually make this level so much easier, at least in terms of dealing with the enemies that are scattered throughout. It's not going to help us very much with the platforming that we have to do. The platforming will still be a little bit of a challenge. You have to be real careful with the platforming in this stage. But in terms of dealing with a lot of the enemies here, this power-up is definitely very useful. You can almost cheese the level with this power-up. Case in point, the Hammer Suit's hammers can destroy thwomps. Yes, the big, bad, intimidating thwomps who aren't afraid to drop down and crush you like a bug. Even they are no match for the power of the hammer. You can even take out Booze. So this is a very nice power-up indeed. Another bonus with the Hammer Suit is that when you're ducking, you are immune to fireballs, so enemies like this fire-spitting piranha plant aren't much of a hassle. However, you want to hang on to this power-up as best you can, because this is a very rare power-up. As far as I know, you can only really get the Hammer Suit via Toad Houses, and only certain Toad Houses at that. You're never really going to find this power-up in a power-up block. So once you get it, hold on to it. Don't use it unless it's like absolutely necessary, like if there's a certain level where you know it's going to be useful, then you can try and use it. But for the most part, you want to hang on to it as best you can. Now, this is a pretty risky jump. I hate this pipe, I hate this pipe, I hate this pipe. Made it! Also, another note I want to make about the Hammer Suit, since it's so powerful and everything. That's probably why it didn't appear in an official Mario game for a very long time. After this game, I believe this power-up did not return until Super Mario 3D World. Super Mario 3D World came out in 2013. That's a 25-year gap between this game, which originally came out in Japan in 1988, and Super Mario 3D World. So that's a long time for a power-up to not appear and then reappear. Also, we have a dick-headed trap right here, if I say so myself. You have to slide under to avoid the fireball, and then you have to quickly move to avoid getting crushed by the thwomp. Luckily, with the Hammer Suit, you know, it's not so bad because we can destroy the Thwomps, yay! Which is just brilliant. And it's our old buddy Boom Boom. Nothing I need to say about him. Like really, what else can I say about Boom Boom that I haven't already said before? We've kicked his butt so many times. I know he's got that one victory against me, but he hasn't had a good record against us. Now we're gonna move on to the final Piranha Plant stage. So we're gonna equip a Starman and we're just gonna run right through it. No questions asked. This one I think is actually easier than the previous one because this one is actually shorter, which makes it a little more tolerable in my opinion. Look at that. Although I did have a Starman, which did make it a lot easier as well. We only get a mushroom out of that, but hey, it's better than nothing. And now, ladies and gentlemen, there is only one level separating us from finishing World 7 finally. But before we go any further, I'm actually going to ditch the Hammer Brothers suit, as much as it pains me. I'm going to go ahead and switch to Raccoon Mario here. Have a feeling it might be a little more useful in the upcoming level. And let's go ahead and do this. And for the final time in this game, we have a king that we need to rescue. And fittingly for this world, he's been transformed into a piranha plant. So here we go, folks. For the last time, it's time to assault an airship once again and get a magic wand. However, this level is not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy to rescue the final king of this game because we're going to be dealing with some pretty nasty obstacles here. Flamethrowers, moving platforms, some pretty precarious jumps, and of course, the final Koopaling of the game, Ludwig von Koopa, who's waiting for us at the end of this stage. He's got some pretty nasty tricks up his sleeve as well, both in the stage itself and his fight, so we need to be ready for just about anything. Luckily, if we can hang on to Raccoon Mario, I'm confident we'll be able to make it through in one piece. We can always hold on to that hope that we will be victorious. If we believe in ourselves, I'm sure we can get the job done. So far, we're doing pretty well making it past the Rocky Wrenches. Yeah, they certainly love their wrenches, don't they? Tell you what, they want to keep throwing wrenches at me. I know a good place where they can stuff them. But that's just me. This part can be a little bit painful to get through because of the fact that the platforms are spaced apart where, you know, pretty good spacing of the platforms here, and especially having to rely, you might have to rely on some of these blue cogs and whatnot that move, and you have to jump and move with them or else you're gonna fall off. They can be a bit annoying to deal with, but we're gonna make a nice long jump right there, and we should be at the end. That should have been the last hurdle before the final warp pipe, and indeed it is. So here we go, folks. It's time for the final Koopaling encounter, Big Bad Ludwig von Koopa. Big danger with this dude is that when he jumps and comes down, he creates an earthquake, and if you get caught in that earthquake, he will stun you, so you need to be very careful. Alright, let's try that again. Hopefully with a better result this time. So like I was saying, when Ludwig hops around and whatnot, he will try to stun you by shaking the ground, and that will leave you vulnerable. Luckily, the second try is the charm, and the final Koopaling has been defeated. So, we've defeated the seven Koopalings, we've rescued all seven kings. But something tells me we're still not done with this game quite yet. Oh, thank heavens! Thank you so much. Here is a letter from the princess. Let's hear it. Whoa, that is not from the princess. Yo, I kidnapped the princess while you were running around. She's here in my castle if you dare to try and rescue her. Ha ha ha. King of the Koopa. Well, we shouldn't have to take three guesses as to who this letter is from. That's right. You didn't think Bowser was involved in this? Well, you must be crazy. Yes, the King of the Koopas, or King of the Koopa, as this game puts it, Big Bad Bowser himself is involved. And as it turns out, rescuing those kings and fighting the Koopalings was all a ploy. It was a distraction so Bowser could go after Princess Peach himself and kidnap her. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have made it to World 8, Dark Land, the final world of the game, and by far the most challenging. But if you want to see World 8 and all that it holds, you're going to have to wait until the next episode because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Super Mario Bros. 3 playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.